Welcome, everybody, to witness the organization of the city government for the year 2018. So without any further hesitation, I'd like to introduce Timothy J. Cruz, Councilor of Ward 1. Dennis B. Henry, Councilor of Ward 3, Dean of the Council. And Lorraine, Councilor of Ward 5. Jack Lally, Councilor of Ward 6. Shirley Azak, Council of Ward 7. Councilor at Large, Jean B. Duranicourt. Councilor at Large, Moise Rodriguez. Councilor Winthrop H. Fowle Jr., Council at Large. Outgoing President, Councilor Robert F. Sullivan. Council at Large. School Committee, Thomas J. Minicello, Ward 1, Vice Chair. Ward 2, Lisa M. Plant. Ward 4, Brent Gormley. Ward 5, Judy Sullivan. Ward 6, Joyce Azak. Ward 7, Timothy J. Sullivan. Ladies and gentlemen, your councilors for the City of Brockton and your school committee for the years 2018 and 2019.
Good morning. First, I'm going to get organized my way. There we go. I just want to take time to welcome all of you here this morning for the inauguration ceremonies for Mayor of the City of Brockton, members of the Brockton City Council, and the Brockton School Committee for our next term beginning 2018, which is today, January 1st. It's New Year's Day, but being New Year's Day, we have to organize on the first Monday. That's the way government is set up. And that's why we're here today. And I'm happy to see that all of my colleagues and city council and school committee members, their eyes are bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. Obviously, they stayed in last night. Well, I don't know about that. But in any case, we are ready to commence with what we have to do here today to take the oaths of office. So with that being said, I want to wish all of you a very healthy and happy, prosperous 2018. And let's look forward to the year to be bright and cheery. And I know that it will. A lot of hurdles to cross, as we always do in each and every year, but I'm sure that we'll make it. So,
yes, Mr. President Pro Temp, the mayor has been notified that the city council has organized a temporary organization.
Councilor Azak.
Mr. President Pro Temp, the mayor's credentials have been examined and found to be in order.
That report is placed on file. At this particular time, I'm going to appoint Councilors Beauregard, McCastro, and Duranicourt to please go down and escort the mayor to the podium.
right hand. Insert your name after I. Repeat after me.
I, Bill Carpenter.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance.
To the Commonwealth of Massachusetts.
To the Commonwealth of Massachusetts.
And will support the Constitution thereof.
And will support the Constitution thereof.
So help me God.
So help me God.
I,
Bill Carpenter.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will faithfully and impartially.
That I will faithfully and impartially.
Discharge and perform.
Discharge and perform.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
As mayor to the city of Brockton.
As mayor to the city of Brockton.
According to my understanding.
According to my understanding.
Agreeably to the rules and regulations.
Agreeably to the rules and regulations.
Of the Commonwealth.
Of the Commonwealth.
And the ordinances of the city of Brockton.
And the ordinances of the city of Brockton.
So help me God.
So help me God.
I,
Bill Carpenter.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Insert your name after I and repeat after me.
I
do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance.
To the Commonwealth of Massachusetts.
To the Commonwealth of Massachusetts.
And will support the Constitution thereof.
And will support the Constitution thereof.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will faithfully and impartially.
That I will faithfully and impartially.
Discharge and perform.
Discharge and perform.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
As a counselor to the city of Brockton.
As a counselor to the city of Brockton.
According to the best of my ability and understanding.
According to the best of my ability and understanding.
Agreeably to the rules and regulations of the Commonwealth.
Agreeably to the rules and regulations of the Commonwealth.
And the ordinances of the city of Brockton.
And the ordinances of the city of Brockton.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
Congratulations, ladies and gentlemen.
Again, Tony, huh?
Again.
Again.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk, and congratulations to the members of the Brockton City Council for commencing their next term starting today, 2018. Congratulations. Councilors.
Right hand, insert your name after I and repeat after me. Aye. Do solemnly swear. That I will bear true faith and allegiance. To the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. And will support the Constitution thereof. So help me God. Aye. Do solemnly swear. That I will faithfully and impartially. Discharge and perform. All the duties incumbent upon me. As a member of the Brockton School Committee. According to the best of my ability and understanding. Agreeably to the rules and regulations of the Commonwealth. And the ordinances of the City of Brockton. So help me God. Aye. Do solemnly swear. That I will support the Constitution of the United States. Congratulations, ladies and gentlemen.
It's going to give me great pleasure to introduce to you for his address, the Honorable Mayor of the City of Brockton, Mayor Bill Carpenter.
Good morning, everyone. City Council, members of the School Committee, our State Legislative Delegation, Mr. Clerk, members of the clergy, colleagues, family, and friends. Welcome to today's inaugural ceremonies and Happy New Year. As we welcome back all seven members of the school committee who continue their service to the city, we acknowledge the departure of two city councilors and welcome their replacements. We thank Councilor-elect Shayna Barnes for her two terms of service, while remembering the historical significance of her election as the first African-American woman to serve on the City Council. We also thank retiring Woodford City Councilor Paul Studensky, not just for his work on the City Council, but for a lifetime of public service to the City of Brockton. I look forward to working with the two new councilors, Susan Castro of Ward 4 and Councilor-at-Large Jean Bradley Durenincourt, the first ever Haitian-American elected to the Brockton City Council. The number one priority of this administration has been and will always be public safety. We are arresting criminals and removing guns and drugs off of our streets at a rate that is simply unprecedented. Over the past 2 years, we have seized over 200 guns from our neighborhoods and have kicked in the doors of over 130 drug dealers, conducting raids and confiscating guns and drugs. Our commitment to increasing the number of officers in our police department and their close collaboration with state, county, and federal law enforcement agencies has made life very difficult for criminals to do business in our city. If you're dealing drugs or committing violent crimes here in the city, we have a simple message for you. It's time to leave. We know that a significant portion of our gun violence is related to drug dealing, and that most property crime is committed by individuals trying to support a drug habit. Any strategy to effectively reduce crime must address the underlying cause of drug addiction. In Brockton, we do have a strategy. The Champion Plan, our model of police-assisted recovery, offers any individual seeking treatment assistance simply by walking into the police station and asking for help. Since the inception of the Champion Plan 22 months ago, we have helped over 500 individuals and made 775 placements into addiction treatment. Not only is the Champion Plan saving lives, but it is changing the perceptions of both police and individuals struggling with addiction towards each other. The success of our Champion Plan is not going unnoticed, as we are receiving national recognition. Just a few weeks ago, I was invited by the Kennedy School of Government at Harvard University to present the Champion Plan to about 40 new mayors from across the country. Protecting the safety of all of our residents is more than just guns and drugs, though. Regrettably, in the year 2017, the city had 7 homicides, 4 of which were cases of domestic violence. This is a much different fight. We are committing additional resources into both prevention and intervention in order to protect potential victims of domestic violence before an assault takes place. As part of this expanded commitment, we have just assigned an additional female police officer to our community policing unit. She will join Officer Fonz in promoting domestic violence awareness throughout the community while also working one-on-one with victims. 1 week from today, our newest class of 15 police officers will enter the academy. 11 of them are here with us this morning, and I'd like to ask them to please stand up and be recognized. Cities like Brockton rely upon the state's Chapter 70 local aid to education for about 80% of its school funding. Under the Chapter 70 Foundation formula, the city contributes about 20%. And in fact, Brockton has exceeded its net school spending obligation in fiscal year 17 and is budgeted to do so again in fiscal year 18. The city is more than meeting its obligation to the schools. However, over the past several years, the state has failed to meet its obligation to Brockton. We will continue to send to the schools every available dollar that we can find. Tomorrow, I will file with the City Council a request for an appropriation of $386,000 for school transportation expenses in order to preserve the current number of school buses and the current student walk zones for the remainder of this school year. Additionally, I have approved a disbursement of $509,000 from the cable TV revolving account to replace the outdated sound and lighting systems at the Brockton High School auditorium. These revolving account funds are not taxpayer dollars. They are revenues generated from the city's contract with Comcast. These two additional expenditures represent another $900,000 of funding for our school system. Today, we are working closely with our state legislative delegation to fight for every state education dollar possible for our students. This year, the City Council approved our request for $100,000 in the city solicitor's budget so that we could go forward with an equity in education lawsuit to force the Commonwealth to properly fund the Brockton Public Schools and the rules of the state constitution. Brockton children deserve the same education and resources as children from more affluent communities like Wellesley and Duxbury. While we lead the fight to force the state to fund education fairly, we must live within our means. I am opposed to any Prop 2.5 tax increase, even for such a worthy purpose as funding of school budgets. Raising taxes even further for Brockton homeowners and businesses is not the answer. The answer is to force the state to pay its fair share. Cities like Brockton across the Commonwealth are all faced with the same reality in trying to balance their budgets. Expenses are increasing faster than revenues, creating a structural deficit that we must attempt to overcome each year. For each of the past 4 years, we have cut millions of dollars from the city budget, allowing us to maintain the lowest average residential property tax bill in Metro South. But despite these budget cuts, we have seen tax increases. We must be more receptive to new construction and new commercial development so that we can continue to grow the tax base. The only way to control new taxes in the future is to attract new business and encourage new development. During the coming months, we will partner with the City Council to pass common sense zoning reform changes along with the creation of new zoning that will support business development while protecting our residential neighborhoods. We need growth of the tax base, not increases of the tax rate. We want more taxpayers, not more taxes paid by the same payers. Simply, we must stop going back to the same residents and businesses for more and more money each year. Despite the challenges we face, we have a lot to look forward to in the coming months. On April 1st, we will roll out our new curbside trash and recycling program. While you'll be hearing the details over the next 90 days, I can tell you that our new system will include new carts with wheels and covers for both trash and recycling, as I'm sure you've seen in other communities. These carts will be provided. These carts will be provided at no cost to our residents. We will be converting to single-stream recycling, and most importantly, there will be no increase in the trash fee. So our new trash and recycling program will keep the city cleaner, encourage recycling, and spread costs more fairly with no increase in the trash fee. I'd like to thank Ward 7 City Councilor Shirley Asak for her participation representing the City Council on the Refuse Contract Review Committee. We will also see the installation of our new LED streetlights completed this spring. These LED lights shine 50% brighter and use less than half the electricity of the old streetlights. The energy savings alone will pay for the lights in just 2.5 years, while these light fixtures with smart technology come with a 10-year warranty. Currently, we have about 50% of the new LEDs installed, so if we've not made it to your street yet, we will be there very soon. With the council's support, we will move forward on the construction of the downtown parking garage, potentially breaking ground this summer. During the upcoming year, you should see 2 or 3 more buildings being demolished, clearing the way for new development downtown that will generate new tax revenues to the city. That is progress. Recent news events have raised all of our awareness with regards to sexual harassment in the workplace. At my request, our Director of Personnel has engaged All One Health, our employee assistant program administrator, to develop and implement sexual harassment training for all city employees. When I took office 4 years ago, the city had not held a real estate auction for 5 years. I appointed a real estate custodian tasked with evaluating the inventory of vacant properties and identifying those valuable for auction at no cost to the taxpayers. This program has been a huge success, generating more than $2.8 million back to the city while stabilizing neighborhoods and bringing these non-performing properties back onto the city's tax rolls. However, I've listened carefully to the questions and concerns posed by some members of the City Council. In the spirit of working collaboratively with the council, It is my intention to assign the duties of the real estate custodian to the city solicitor's office. I hope the city council will view this decision as a sign of good faith on my part. We're committed to improving the quality of life in every neighborhood of our city, every block, every street, every corner. Our new quality of life task force is positioned to respond immediately to issues that negatively impact our neighborhoods. Working with the National Resource Network, we plan to lift up and build on neighborhood strengths to help bridge the city's communications with its neighbors, as well as communications between neighbors. To this end, we are establishing new and strengthening existing neighborhood associations through resident leadership. In just a few days, we will join the New England Patriots as we cut the ribbon on our new playground at Kennedy Park. Through the generosity of the New England Patriots Foundation, the J. Lorenzo Company, and J.K. Holmgren Engineering, along with our commitment to the federal CDBG dollars, this $250,000 playground has been built with no local taxpayer money. Twenty-eight years ago, 16-year-old Jennifer Lynn Fay disappeared from the city's north side, never to be seen again. This spring, we will return to McKinley Park to dedicate the new playground in Jennifer's memory. I'd like to extend our thanks to the Parks Commission for approving the naming of the playground after Jennifer Lynn Fay, and also to Jennifer's mom, Dottie McClain, who now finally will have a place to be with her daughter. Air quality on the city's south side has been the subject of much discussion for years prior to my becoming mayor. I believe the residents of the city will be pleased to hear that we have notified the MassDEP that effective today, we will begin shutting down the incinerator to the city's wastewater treatment plant. It will cease operation completely within 30 days. That incinerator, I knew I could count on your support on that one, Michelle. That incinerator that has been burning sludge from the sewer treatment plant 24 hours a day, 7 days a week for decades, will no longer operate. Today is New Year's Day, so as we bring in the new year, I do feel obligated to make a New Year's resolution. So I'm resolving to improve communication between my office and the City Council. Councilors, we don't always have to agree, but the residents of this city expect us to always work together for the betterment of the city. The most effective communication is two-way communication. Communicating is kind of like dancing. One looks pretty foolish doing it alone. I can't address councilors' concerns by reading about them in the newspaper. But councilors, give me a chance. I'm willing to work with you. Towards that goal, I've already reached out to Council President DeAnary, and we have agreed to begin meeting weekly starting tomorrow. Henry Ford once said, if everyone is moving forward together, then success takes care of itself. Let's continue to keep Brockton moving forward together, then success will take care of itself. We know the challenges are many, but if we work together, we can get a lot accomplished. Let's get to work. Thank you. Happy New Year.